Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. As you can tell probably by the title of this video, today's video is going to be on my self-tanning routine. I get a lot of questions about what products I use and how I go about making it look as natural as possible. So if you want to see my current tanning routine, then just keep watching. All right, so I just got out of the shower and my hair is still wet, so I threw it up into a ponytail. I always recommend throwing it up into a ponytail or a bun or leaving it in a towel to air dry while you're self-tanning, because you don't want your wet hair to get onto your newly, freshly applied tan. That could leave streaks or marks, so I definitely recommend just throwing it up and out of the way. I think one of the biggest steps to getting a nicely applied, perfect tan is the prep that goes into it beforehand. So while I'm in the shower, I like to exfoliate my skin. Exfoliating your skin will just get rid of dead skin cells, get rid of any oils that are left over on your body or any product that's kind of built up on your skin. And to exfoliate my skin, I like to use the Loving Tan polishing glove. So that's this right here. Mine's still wet from the shower. But what it is, it's basically just a glove that has a little bit of a rough surface to it, which will help then exfoliate your body. I especially like to focus on areas that tend to be a bit more dry. So the tops of my hands, my elbows, knees, feet, but I do like to apply it everywhere as well and just give my body a wipe down so it's nice and prepped and nice and smooth so the tan can lay on it nicer. When you're exfoliating your skin, you can use scrubs. That helps and that works too, but I personally don't like to use them because sometimes they can have oils in them, which can then leave a barrier on your skin between your self-tanner and your skin. So I find that sometimes it can get a little bit streaky or maybe not give you the best tan possible. So I personally love to use the polishing glove. So my personal favorite shade for myself in the winter months is the Loving Tan Deluxe Bronzing Mousse in the shade Medium. This just gives me the perfect natural tan. It's not too dark, it's not too light. It just gives me a nice glow. In the summer months, I do like to use their deeper shades when I do have more of a natural tan going on. One of the reasons why I love this shade so much is because it's just such a natural tone. It has a little bit of like a red tint to it, which will give you the most natural color. It's not green toned or orange toned, so it truly does look like you've been in the sun. So to apply my self-tanner, I like to use a mitt. I always recommend using some kind of mitt while you're self-tanning so you don't get that awful orange hands that you can see a lot of the times. This also just helps it blend in so much easier than your hands do. And with any purchase of Loving Tan Mousse, if you're interested, you can use coupon code KelseyRay to get a free mitt if you're interested, which honestly, if you are buying it, I highly recommend using the code just so you get this free little gift with it, because this is so worth it. It will make your self-tan go on so much easier and it will honestly save your life. All right, so now I'm going to apply my self-tanner. Obviously, if I was doing this off camera, I would be completely naked. And when I do it, I like to apply it on my legs first. So I like to start at my legs and then stomach, and then I usually do my chest and arms and my face last. That's personally just how I like to do it, but kind of whatever works for you. But for video purposes, obviously, I don't want to show you everything. So I will just be doing my top half. So I'm going to start with my arms. So I'm going to apply two pumps. All right, so it'll look like that. And then what I like to do is I like to kind of wipe it down my arms and then I will blend it in circular motions. So I just kind of get the color on like that and then I start wiping and blending it in. If you have dry skin, you will want to work a little bit fast because this product does dry down really quick. All right, and then I'm going to do one and a bit more pumps. And this time I'm going to focus on the under part of my arms. I like to apply it all over, on top of my arms, under my arms, blending it kind of back here into like my shoulder area. And then when I have less product on my glove, I will apply it onto my hands. Dry areas of your body will absorb it faster and more than other areas of your body, so always being a bit more sparing on your wrists, fingers, elbows, areas like that. So the color you see going on right now is just a color guard. This isn't your actual tan. So if you do see some streaks or if things aren't blending completely, don't worry. This is just a cosmetic bronzer just so you can kind of see where your tan is going. That's another reason why I love this product, is because I want to see where my color is going. So I love that it has a color guard and I know where I'm applying myself tanner. And then I took about 2 more pumps and I'm going to apply it to my chest. The shade that I'm using develops in about 6 to 8 hours. So what I like to do is I like to apply it at night and then just go right to bed. It's super fast drying, so I don't have to wait too long before putting on my PJs and heading into bed. If you are a bit more of an impatient person, they do have a 2-hour express one, which is also really good. But for me personally, I always apply it at night. So I just would prefer to just sleep in it and then just rinse off in the morning. So when it comes to the face, you can kind of decide what you like personally. I like to apply it to my face. It has never broken me out or caused any acne or clogged pores or irritations. So what I like to do is just take whatever's left over onto my mitt and just wipe it onto my face. I know a lot of people don't like to apply self-tanner to their face because you tend to exfoliate your face more anyway, so it never lasts quite as long. But I still like to get a few days of a nice glow on my face. All right, so now that I did that, I'm going to go and apply it to the rest of my body. Then I'm going to go and head to bed and I will come back in the morning all rinsed off and show you the final results. So I guess I will see you all in the morning and good night. Good morning, I am back. I just finished showering and getting ready and I rinsed off my tan. And now this is what I am left with after about 6 to 8 hours of development time. As you can see, the color is just perfect. It's not too tanned, but just still gives me a nice glow to my skin. Definitely looks natural. When you first wake up, you might look a little muddy or dirty looking, and you might have some streaks just by how you've been sleeping overnight. But honestly, don't worry. That's just the cosmetic bronzer on top of your actual tan. Once you shower off, you're left with your nice, even tan. So when I'm in the shower, rinsing off my tan, I don't use any body wash or scrubs, anything like that. I just like to use my hands and just kind of go like this and just wipe off any of that kind of color guard that's on top of my skin. So to make sure your tan lasts as long as possible and to fade as nicely as possible, you want to make sure you moisturize really well. I like to use unscented lotion or something with not too much like perfume in it, because sometimes the perfumes in lotions can strip your tan. So something just nice and natural, apply that every time you get out of the shower and it will definitely help your tan fade nicer. For me, I find that my tan usually lasts somewhere between 7 to 10 days, depending how much I'm showering, sweating, things like that. So I hope you all enjoyed watching my self-tanning routine. If you are interested in any of the products I mentioned, I will list them down below with their website and all that good stuff. And then if you are interested in the Deluxe Mint, I will have my coupon code down below as well. I hope you all have an amazing day and I will see you in the next video. Bye guys!